have to do it again.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Longer than like people think about their senior project, but I was just so excited to do do this, and I knew that's what I was going to do. And I have never been in a 9th and 10th grade play, so this was a little scary, but I'm really happy with the way it turned out, and I'm so proud of these guys. So I hope you enjoy it. Sit back, relax, and enjoy the show.
Again, step, kick, 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 touch. 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 Right. That connects with turn, turn, out, in, jump, step, step, kick, 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 touch. Got it? Okay. This is the whole combination facing away from the mirror. So working from the top. 5, 6, 7, 8. I'm going to put you into your groups now. When I call out your number, I'll tell you where you're going to be in the formation.
Oh, God, I forgot my number.
Right. When I find a number without a person, it's you. Number 2, downstage. Number 9, upstage. Number 10, downstage. Number 23, upstage. 23, Judy Turner.
23.
Number 81, downstage. Number 5, upstage. Okay, let's do the ballet combination. First group of girls, second group follow. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Diana, you're dancing with your tongue out again. Girl in blue, much better. Still too much tension in the face, neck, and shoulders. Relax. Dance out. Hold it, hold it, stop. Sheila, do me a favor. You dance upstage. You downstage. Do you know the combination?
I knew it when I was in the front.
Okay, boys, stay in the formation. any Broadway shows?
No.
Broadway shows?
Lori.
Today, I want you to tell me your stage name, real name if it's different. I also want you to know where you were born and how old you are.
Terrific.
Fabulous.
Excuse me, sir, do we have to? I mean, it's not very polite to ask one her age.
Being polite doesn't interest me. Your age does. I want to know your age. Okay, we'll start at the end, stage right.
28.
Start with your name and step forward. Next.
Maggie Winslow.
Louder.
Maggie Winslow, sometimes known as Margaret, Marge, or Peggy, whatever, it's real. I was born at 10:03 p.m. on a rainy Tuesday evening in San Diego, California, and I'm 25.
Okay, next.
I'm Michelle Costa. I used to be Costa Pallone. I was born in Trenton, New Jersey on the 4th of July, and I'm 24.
Hi, I'm Connie McKenzie. Actually, Connie Edgemame Sue McKenzie. But don't tell, and I was born on Groundhog's Day in North Carolina.
Cassie? Zach, could I talk to you for a minute?
Sure, go ahead.
I mean privately.
Not right now, Cassie. I'm like an hour behind.
Well, I know, but...
Next.
I'm Sheila Bryant, really Sarah Rosemary Bryant, which I really hate. I was born in Colorado Springs, Colorado, and I'm gonna be 30 real soon, and I'm real.
I'm Robert Charles Joseph Henry Mills III, and that's my real name too. I was born in upstate New York, near Buffalo. I can't remember the name of the town, I blocked it out. I was born 25 years ago.
Hi, my name is Bebe Betzenheimer, and I know I gotta change it. I'm 22, from Boston, and here I am!
My real name is Lana Turner. No, it's always been Judy Turner. And I'm 26 years old. Oh, and I was born in El Paso, Texas.
Okay, next.
Hi, I'm Richie Walters. I'm 27 years old, and I was born on a full moon in Herculaneum, Missouri.
I'm Allie DeLuca. I'm 30, and I'm from the Bronx.
I'm Christine DeLuca.
Evelyn DeLuca, and I'll be 23 on September 1st.
Tell me where you're from.
Oh, and I'm from the Bronx.
Well, as far as I'm concerned, I'm Valerie Clark, but my parents think I'm Margaret Mary Houlihan. Couldn't you just die?
I was born in the middle of nowhere, a little town called Stanton, Virginia. Bye-bye.
How old are you?
Old. No, 20.
Mark Philip Lawrence Tambor. Templar is our Mach 20.
Oh, jeez.
And if I get this show, I'll work really hard.
Don't let him bug you.
My name is Paul San Marco, real name Efron Ramirez. I was born in Spanish Harlem, and I'm 27.
My name is Diana Morales, and I
didn't change it because I figured ethnic was in. 27, you got that? And I was born on a Hollywood bed in the Bronx.
Go on.
Come on, what? Oh, do you want to know the color of my eyes and how tall I am, or how many shows I've done?
I know. How it was not mine.
Like what?
Talk about yourself.
Talk about what?
Tell me about the Bronx.
The Bronx? What's to tell about the Bronx? It's up, down, to the right.
What did you do there?
The Bronx? Mostly waiting to get out.
Why did you start dancing?
Who knows? I always jumped around and danced. Hey, do you want to know if I can act? Give me a scene to read. I'll act.
Then relax.
Look, I really don't mind talking, but just hand me over first, please.
You want this job, don't you?
Oh, yeah, sure, I want the job.
Okay, Diana, back in line. Before we do any more dancing, and we will be dancing some more, let me explain something. I'm looking for a strong dancing chorus. I need people who look terrific together, and that can work together as a team. Now, I have your pictures and resumes. I know what shows you've been in, but that's not gonna help you. And I don't want to give you just a few lines to read. I think it would be better if I knew something about you, about your personalities. And I don't want you to think that you have to perform. I just want to hear you talk and be yourself. And everybody, please relax as much as you can. Sheila?
How many people do you want?
8 boys and girls.
Need any?
Okay, Michelle, I'll start with you.
Me? Don't you want to start at the end?
No, I'll start with you. And relax.
I could if you started at the end. What do you want to know?
What do you want to tell me?
I would like to tell you to start at the end. I can't think of a thing.
Yes, you can. Why did you start dancing?
Oh, because my sister did. I come from this big Italian family. I was the last of 12. I was an accident. That's what my sister told me. Oh, that was the sister, Rosalie. She was the one who started taking dance lessons. My mother would take her every Saturday. Sometimes she'd take me too. I liked going.
How old were you?
4. And I'd sit there all perky and I'm watching Cisco pitter pat. Said, I can do that. I can do that.
Truth.
I'll take the truth.
Well, to be begin with, I come from this quasi-upper middle class family type town, and I was the strange one.
How strange?
Real, real strange. I used to love to give garage recitals, bizarre recitals. This one time, we did Frankenstein as a musicale, and I spray painted this kid silver all over. We had to rush him to the hospital, though, because he had that thing where your horse can't breathe. Luckily, I didn't paint the soles of his feet, and as I got older, I kept getting stranger and stranger. I used to go outside my house to this busy intersection at rush hour, and I'd direct traffic. I just wanted to see if anybody would notice me. And that's when I started breaking into people's houses. I didn't steal anything. I just rearranged their furniture. School. You want to hear about school? I was the kid that was always getting slammed into lockers and stuff like that. And not only by the students, but by the teachers too. Oh, and I hated sports. Hated sports. And sports were very big. I mean, it was Jock City, but I didn't make one team. See, I couldn't catch a ball that had Elmer's glue on it. And wouldn't my father have to be this big ex-football hero? He was so humiliated, he didn't know what to tell his friends. Thank you.
Okay. Sheila.
Yes? You want me?
Yes.
He wants me.
To talk.
Right. What do you want to know about me first?
Why are you in this business?
Well, I wanted to be a prima ballerina. That light, what color is that? Do you have anything softer?
Don't worry about the lights. Just talk.
Well, I wanted to be a prima ballerina because my mother was a ballerina until my father made her give it up.
Sure, come downstage. Closer.
Can I sit on your lap?
Oh. Do you always come on like this?
No, sometimes I'm aggressive. I'm very strong.
Maybe too strong.
Am I doing something you don't like? I mean, you told me to be myself.
Just bring it down a little.
Bring what down?
Your attitude. Tell me about your parents.
My parents?
Your father.
Him.
Your mother.
My mother.
My mother was raised like a little nun. She couldn't go out. She couldn't even babysit.
Sheila, don't perform. Just talk.
But she wanted to be a dancer and she had all these scholarships. My father made her give it up. Isn't this exciting? And then she had this daughter, me, and she made her what she wanted to be. And she was fabulous in the way she did it. Do you want to know how she did it?
Go on.
Well, first she took me to see all the ballets, and then she gave me her old toe shoes, which I used to run down the sidewalks in on my toes at 5. And then when she saw I really had to dance, she said, "You can't do it until you're 8. Well, by then I was only 6, and I said, "But I've got to dance! I mean, anything to get out of the house."
What?
Nothing.
What did you just say?
I just said that I wanted to get out of the house.
Why?
The truth.
Sure, you're strong enough.
Well, let's face it. My family scene was not good. Daddy always thought that marriage needs him. That's what he said. When he proposed, he informed my mother he was probably her very last chance. And though she was 22, she married him. Life with my dad wasn't ever a picnic, more like a come as you are. When I was 5, I remember my mother dug earrings out of her car. I knew that they weren't hers, but it wasn't something you want to discuss. He wasn't warm. Well, not to her. Well, not to us. But everything was beautiful at the ballet. Graceful men with lovely girls in white. Yes. Thank you.
class. Up the steep and very narrow stairway to the voice like a metronome. Up the steep and very narrow stairway. It was in paradise.
It was in paradise.
It was in paradise, but it was home. Mother always said I'd be very attractive when I grew up, when I grew up. Different, she said, with a special something and a very, very personal flair. And though I was 8 or 9, though I was 8 or 9, though I was 8 or 9, I hated her. Now, different is nice, but it sure isn't pretty. Pretty isn't what it's about. I never met anyone who was different, couldn't figure that out. So beautiful, I never lived to see. But it was clear, if not to her, well then to me, that everyone was beautiful.
I'll never forget it. He put me up against this teleprompter, one of those great big square.
a minute and pull yourself together.
For her, this is together.
She's right.
Anyways, I always knew what I wanted to do. I wanted to be like all the people in the movies.
Except I had this little,
problem.
See, I really couldn't sing. I could never really sing. What I couldn't do was
sing.
I have trouble with the notes.
It's just
terrifying.
See,
I really couldn't hear which note was lower or was higher. Which is why it disappears.
Hoping and praying, I
my whole trip, my size, and still is. God, my last show, I was 32, and I played a 14-year-old brat. But I don't look it, and I shouldn't knock it, because I have always been able to work. From the time I was five, that summer stuck, up till now, I never stopped.
And the teacher, Mr. Park, puts us up on stage with our legs around each other, up one and back of the other. He says, okay, today we're going to do improvisations now. You're on a bobsled and it's snowing out and it's cold. Okay, go.
She comes down. top of her big pink convertible. And as I'm tripping out my top, she was all ready to dance. We go down the block with her red flowing hair blowing in the wind.
Steve McQueen in the can, not allowed to the Yes. not?
I don't know why, I just didn't.
Well, what did you do?
Not much.
Paul, you must have done something. How old were you when you started dancing?
16.
Okay, so until you were 16, what did you do? What was your family like?
We were close.
Close? Brothers? Sisters?
Two sisters. One died when I was 14.
How?
Why do I have to talk about this? I really don't want to talk about
Lori,
this.
Lori, can we please sit down?
Zach, can we sit down?
Yes, can the adults please sit down?
Okay, everybody take a break out in the hall. Paul, we'll try this again later. Cassie, stay on stage, please.
Well, this audition is really interesting, isn't it?
Yeah. What are you doing?
What do you think? I need a job.
In the chorus.
Look, Zach, I love a part, of course, but I'll take what I can get.
You're too good for the chorus, Cassie.
Too good? I did a couple of dance parts. So what?
You were featured. You stopped two shows cold. Your career was going fine here in New York.
Can't get a job, Zach. God, you sound like all my friends, my fans, acting like I'm a star and don't know it. And the truth is, I never even came close. Nobody has things to tell me. Well, it would be nice to be a star, but I'm not. I'm a dancer. Give me somebody to dance for. Give me somebody to show. Let me wake up in the morning to find I have somewhere exciting to go.
So, you're going through a slope here. It happens to everybody. Something will happen.
That's what I kept telling myself in California. And kept telling myself that and telling myself that. Well, nothing will happen. Can't act.
What?
I can't act. And there I am in California, supposed to be this actress. Well, it didn't take me long to find out I can't act. It didn't take Hollywood long either.
It didn't work out there?
Oh, sure. Rotten part of so-and-so film. Part ended up getting cut. God, I was a go-go dancer in a TV movie of the week. Let's see. Commercials. I almost got a squeeze of roll of toilet paper, but I lost out in the finals. Isn't that something? 17 years in the business and I end up plunking toilet paper squeezing. And I was a dancing band-aid. That was fun. We had an earthquake. I got a terrific tan. You must have heard about.
I did hear you were going out with some big agent. You even wild.
Well, when you're a woman of leisure, what else is there to do but go a bit wild and run around? Not to mention getting fat and going crazy, which is why I came back to New York, which is why I'm here today. Zach, little dear, little pussycat, I need a job. Return to the world of the living by showing me.
You give me a job and the rest of this crap will get solved. I'll need to work, you may think that by now I'm on that. I'll do you proud. The rope of a rope to grab onto. Help me to prove that I am strong. Give me the chance to look forward to say, hey, listen, they're playing my song. Play me the music. Give me the chance to come through. All I ever needed was music and the mirror and the chance to
and how to be a man. And since then I learned that I am one.
Anyway, somebody told me they were looking for male dancers down at the Jewel Box of View, you know, the drag show. So I went, and it's fabulous extension. They told me you're too short to be a boy. Would you like to be a pony? I said, what's that? And they said, a girl. What do I have to do? Come on upstairs. So I went, I hiked up my dungarees and put on a pair of nylon stockings and heels. It was freaky. It's incredible. I was 16 at the time, so I kept it all from my parents, but I was finally in show business. Nothing to brag about, but without an education, you can't get a good job, and it was a job. I had friends. We were working the Apollo Theater on 125th Street, doing four shows a day with the movie. It was really tacky. The show was going to Chicago, and my parents wanted to say goodbye. They were going to drop my luggage off after the show. We were doing this Oriental number where I looked like Anna May Wong. I had these two big great chrysanthemums on either side of my head, and a huge headdress with gold balls all over it. I was going on finale, and going down the stairs, and who should I see standing by the stage door? My parents. I freaked, I didn't know what to do. And I thought, I know, I'll just walk right past them like all the others, and they'll never know it's me. So I went, right as I crossed my mother, I heard her say, oh my God. Well, I died, but what else could I do? I had to go on for the finale. The show. I went backstage, got dressed, and took off my makeup. When I came back downstairs, there were my parents standing in a crowd of all these. And all they said to me was, he's right. Make sure you eat and take care of yourself. And then my father turned to the producer and he said, take care of my son! That was the first time he ever called me that!
Can they come back?
Bring them in.
Okay, everybody in.
Okay, this is the same number we worked on earlier. It also goes with the lyrics that you just learned. Now, this is important. I want to see unison dancing. Every arm, every head, every body angle exactly the same. You must blend. This is one of those numbers where you back the star. You're her frame. I don't want anybody to pull my eye, okay? Let's review it.
Singular sensation.
Five, six.
I don't have a hat.
Hold it, a hat.
Thanks.
station, every little step she takes.
Bring your legs, sure.
One thrilling combination, every note that she makes. One smile and suddenly nobody else
part of the will
do. You know you'll never be lonely with you. Yeah.
Sheila and Richie and Connie, they're all special. I'd be happy to be dancing in that line. Yes, I would. And I'll take chorus. You'll take me.
I'm gonna put you into groups. Dawn, Sheila, Bobby, Michelle, and Bibi. Let me see some smiles. Not that Bodhi self smile. I wanna see that I love to dance smile. Christine, Valerie, Mark, Paul, and Connie. Connie, relax. Loosen up. Enjoy it.
What do you do when you can't dance anymore?
What kind of question is that?
Really happy one.
Yeah.
I don't know. What do you do?
Well, I'll tell you. Because I'm getting scared. See, I love being in this business. My name is okay, Richie. You've been having fun for 8 years now, but where's it getting you?
A lot of people can feel that way lately. They're getting out of the business fast.
Oh no. Please, don't say that. Don't talk about Broadway's dying.
Don't worry, honey. It's not.
You're not doing big shows like we used to.
But even if they did, even if you get the show, it's gonna close one day. Nothing runs forever, right?
Well, yeah, sure. But that's just the way it is.
Right.
Then you gotta start all over. Because the only chorus line you can depend on in this business is the one at unemployment. I just wanted to be the chorus.
Oh, I just wanted to be something other than a tall, skinny one second from the end.
She dances.
I know, don't you just love her?
I want to know what you're going to do when you can't dance anymore.
Well, I don't care if I never dance another step as long as I live. I'd be happy just going out to Hollywood. Big deal, right? I can dream, can't I?
Yeah, but dreams don't exactly pay the rent.
Well, then I'll find somebody who can.
Your body's gonna last forever.
I can't take it.
Well, I'm sorry, but I can't worry about any of that now. Because I plan on kicking these legs as long as I can, and when I can't, well, I'll just do something else.
directing or stage managing someday.
I guess I'll just have to see.
Oh, I can't think of anything else I'd do.
Well, if we want to pick another career, go on. Pick a career. What do you want to be when you grow up?
Young. I know what I'm gonna do. I'm finally gonna be able to get off my diet. Then I'm gonna get in the car with my husband, drive up to our 50 acres in Vermont, have a bunch of kids, dance around the kitchen, cooking, and enjoying getting fat.
That sounds good. Except the fat part.
Yeah.
I'd like that. Just not right away.
Listen, all I want is to be happy.
Well, come on, aren't you happy? Look, I sit around and get depressed and worry about these things too, but then I meet somebody and they say to me, wow, dance on Broadway, how fabulous. You got somewhere, you're something. And I get this feeling inside because I remember when I used to stand outside of that stage door and watch all these girls come out there with their eyelashes and their makeup, and I'd say to myself, God, I'll never be that old. I'll never be that old. I'll never be old enough to come out of that stage door. But deep down inside, I knew I couldn't. Damn, come this far, I'm not giving up now. That's what I used to say. I won't give up. I've got to be a ballerina by the time I'm 18. Well, then I thought I should be doing musical comedies, and I said, okay, I'll be a chorus girl, but I've got to be playing parts by the time I'm 21.
Oh no, you did that too. Give yourself a time limit.
I still do it.
Right.
Then you're 25, anything? Just a couple of years more? Well, hell, I'm 30. How many years left do I have to be a chorus kid? 3, 4? So, lately, I've been thinking about opening up a dance studio.
I don't know. Am I topping out? Am I growing up? I don't know.
Who does? Listen, who knows anything? It's just something you're gonna have to wait and see.
Right, but if today were the day you had to stop dancing, how would you feel?
Can't regret what I did.
wonderful about going through all of this today. I sincerely wish that I could hire all of you, but I can't. Will the following people please step forward? Dawn. Allie. Diana. No, I'm sorry, I'm wrong. Back in line. Christine. Evie. Sheila. Connie. Maggie. Frontline, thank you very much. Thank you. I'm sorry. Rehearsal starts September 22nd. All right, we'll rehearse for 6 weeks with a 2-month out-of-town trial. Our New York opening, sometime mid-January. Be prepared to sign a standard minimum contract with a 6-month rider. You'll be contacted sometime next week as to when and where to sign your contract. And I'm very glad that we're going to be working together.
First of all, this one is for our lovely custodian who has been there every night. Every single night, waiting till 5:30 or 6 to clean up our mess. And if you see the drama room after a rehearsal, you'll know. So thank you so much. Thank you for being a mentor and working on costumes and always having good advice. So